Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can bring in colors into Photoshop from external files. This video is going to be really helpful for designers who are working on designs that require the use of specific colors found on external files. Files such as HTML, CSS, SVG, or even regular JPEG files. Our goal is to create a custom color swatch set that can be used when working on projects that require those specific colors. What we're going to do first is take a logo and use Adobe Color CC to analyze the colors and save those colors to a CC library. Then I'll show you how to take an SVG and CSS file and create color swatch sets from the colors found on those files. The first two examples require Photoshop CC, but the third example can be followed by anyone using older versions of Photoshop. In the third and final example, I'll show you how you can use color tables to grab the full color palette from any photograph and how to save those colors as swatches. We're going to start out by using this logo, the Seaworthy logo. It was designed by my good friend Chris Converse. It was used in a co-presentation that Chris and I did together on designing UI and UX elements at the Creative Pro Conference. Chris is an incredibly talented guy, and he is also a great presenter. You can check him out at chrisconverse.com or check out his courses on both lynda.com and udemy.com. Okay, let's get started with the tutorial. So we're going to work with the Seaworthy logo, and I just want to show you my libraries panel here. If you don't see that, you can go to libraries to enable this icon so you can click on the libraries panel and open it up. Notice that currently I only have a couple graphics here. They're Adobe stock images. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the colors of this logo and put them inside of this libraries panel so that we can have access to them from anywhere or so that we can share them with another Creative Cloud user. Now, we're not actually going to work inside of Photoshop for this. Instead, we're going to use Adobe Color CC. So you need to go into color.adobe.com. So here we are at Adobe Color CC, and I'm logged in. You can see my name there in my picture. So what I want to do now is bring the image onto this website. So I'm going to click on this icon here to create a color theme from a photo. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to select the Seaworthy logo and press open. And that's going to select these colors on that image. Now, it selected two colors from the same shade of blue, so I'm just going to click and drag one of those away and select the gray that makes up the text. I'm going to click and drag that one there to the center so it's not on the edge and selecting that weird color. So now we have the white, the two shades of blue, the orange, and the gray. We can go ahead and save that now. I'm going to click on the Save button here, and I can save this into any Creative Cloud library that I have. I'm going to give it a name, so I'll just call it Seaworthy. I'm just going to add a couple spaces there. And this is where I can choose the library on the Creative Cloud. And the library that I'm going to use is the one that I showed you a minute ago, the one called My Library. I can add some tags if I want to, but I'm not going to do that. And I can click on the Save button. This is going to save this color theme onto the Creative Cloud, and it should be available to us in Photoshop. So I'm going to go ahead and open up Photoshop again. And there it is. Notice that the color themes are here with the same colors found on the logo. If I click on any one of these colors, the foreground color changes to that color. So you can see the blue there and now the orange. I'm going to go ahead and close that panel, and I'm going to show you another way that you can bring in color from different types of files. In this case, I'm going to show you how to bring in colors from HTML, CSS, or SVG files. Photoshop can recognize these types of files and also recognize any of these color syntaxes found here. So what you need to do is go into Window, Swatches. That opens up the Swatches panel, and we can open up any one of these type of files. So I'm going to click on the flyout menu, and I'm going to choose Replace Swatches. And I don't have anything in this folder, or so it seems. If I switch the types of files that I can select to CSS, you'll see a CSS file that I have there, or SVG, you'll see an SVG file that I have here. This is an SVG file of the American flag, so I'm going to go ahead and click on that and open it up, and notice what happens. Now we only have red, white, and blue, the colors of the flag. And I can open up that file just so you can see what it looks like. And there you go, that's the flag, and these are the colors that it took from it. You could also do the same thing for an HTML or CSS file. So I'm just gonna do a CSS file so you can see what that looks like. This time I'm just gonna load swatches, which is gonna load the colors found on that file after the colors found in the SVG file. So I'm gonna go into load swatches, change the file type to CSS. There's my CSS file right there, and click on load. We still have the red, white, and blue, and all the colors found on that CSS file. And I'm gonna pull up the CSS file just so you can see what that looks like. As you can see here, this is the CSS, and wherever Photoshop finds color, it saves it onto a color swatch. So these are all the colors that it found on that particular file. And what I'm gonna show you in this final example is take multiple colors from this image and save them into the swatches panel here, much like we did with the CSS file. So of course you can upload this image onto Adobe Color CC and save it into your library. The problem is that you're gonna get 5 color swatches and you may need a whole lot more than that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna save this as a color table and use that as our swatches. So let me show you how that works. We're gonna go into image, mode, and we're gonna convert this from an RGB image to an index color image. For now, we're gonna leave it at 256 and press OK. So now there's only 256 colors on this image that we're gonna save as color swatches. So I'm gonna go into image again, mode, and this time I'm gonna select color table. And this is our color table right here. And as you can see, these are all the colors found on the image. I'm gonna save these, and I'm just gonna call this table and click on save. And then I can just close this window without doing anything else. So I'm just gonna click on that X and close it. I'm gonna go into the swatches panel on the flyout menu. I'm gonna click on replace swatches. And under the file type, I'm gonna select color table. And there it is, that's the table that we created. Click on load, and now we have the colors found on this image here in the swatches panel. And of course you can click on these swatches and they'll be selected as a foreground color. Another thing that you may want to do is use fewer colors than 256. So if you want less colors, what you can do is set a different number. So let me show you how to do that. I'm going to press Ctrl-Alt-Z, Command-Option-Z on the Mac to undo. So we're back at the RGB color mode. So we're going to go through that one more time. I'm going to click on index color. This time, instead of 256, I'm going to choose 25, press OK. So now this image is made up of 25 different colors, and I can save those colors as we did before. I'm gonna go into image, mode, color table, and here's our 25 colors. And then I can go through the same process of saving the file. In this case, I'll call it table 25, save it. I'm gonna close this, go back into the swatches panel, and again, I'll replace the swatches. And this time I'm just gonna select the 25 file there, click on load, and here we have our 25 colors. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Make sure that you leave all your comments or questions down below. If you create an image using this tutorial or any other of my tutorials, feel free to share it on Instagram with the hashtag PTCVids. I often do a search for this hashtag to see what you're all up to. If I find your image, I will leave you a comment. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click on that like button. If you have a friend who you think will enjoy this tutorial, please share this link with them now. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.